Hello everyone and welcome back to Law Statistics. Today's presentation is based on offences against women. So let's proceed towards the presentation. Crimes against women under the Indian Penal Code. First is the word, gesture or act intended to insult the modesty of a woman under section 509. Then we have importation of girls up to 21 years of age under section 509. And 360B, then we have voyeurism under section 354C, then we have stalking under section 354D, then we have assault under section 354B, then we have sexual harassment under section 354A, then we have outraging the modesty of women under section 354, then cruelty by husband or his relative under 498A, which basically talks about cruelty, then we have dowry death, murder, abetment of suicide under section 302, 304B, and then we have the rape sections from 375. Rape is considered to be a very grievous offense which is constituted against all the women disregarding their age. Rape is a crime not against the person of a woman. It is a crime against the entire society and the cases are expeditiously increasing on daily basis. As per section 376A of IPC, whosoever commits an offence punishable under subsection clause 1 or subsection clause 2 of section 376 in the course of such commission inflicts any injury which causes the death of the woman or causes the woman to be in a precedent vegetative state shall be punished with rigorous imprisonment for a term which shall not less than 20 years but may extend to imprisonment for life, which shall mean imprisonment for the remainder of that person's natural death or with death. Then we have our section 376D, which talks about punishment for gang rape on women under 16 years of age. Also we have section 366B that talks about importation of girls up to 21 years of age. Meanwhile, we have another act also which talks about the rights of children, that is the POCSO Act, and we have section 354C which talks about voyeurism. Then we have section 354D which talks about stalking. It was pursued under any law or to comply with any condition or requirement imposed by any person under any law. Whosoever commits offence of stalking will be punished severely. Then we have section 354D of the IPC states that any man who follows a woman and contacts or attempt to contact such woman to foster personal interaction repeatedly despite a clear indication of a disinterest by such woman or monitor the use of a woman of the interest email or any other form of electronic communication commits the offence of stalking. It was pursued for the purpose of preventing or detecting crime and man accused of stalking had stayed. We have section 354B which talks about assault for use of criminal force on a woman with intent to disrobe, where the punishment extends to 7 years and would be liable for fine too. Whereas we have section 354A which talks about sexual harassment. Also we have a very important act of Sexual Harassment of Women at Workplace Act 2013 which came after the case of Vishakha versus State of Rajasthan. Then we have a very important section, that is the 498A, cruelty by husband or his relatives. Basically it is correlated with the dowry death. Now we have section 354A that is about sexual harassment, whereas several aspects are mentioned under the section which constitute that on what basis the one is considered as a harassment. Now we have dowry death, in which the imprisonment can be raised up to 7 years, which may extend to the imprisonment of life. Then we have section 326A, that is voluntary causing grievous hurt. It's a common section which is available for both men and women. And then we have section 354A, which talks about outraging the modesty of a woman. Then we have an important section, that is section 376D, which talks about gang rape, and in which the imprisonment may extend to life and shall not be less than 20 years. This is the punishment for rape in our country. That's all for the presentation. Thank you and have a great day ahead.